Hello everyone. Today up for sale on eBay is the entire collection of the Carnegie Hall Library of Classical Music. We've actually opened up all of these box sets. They all contain 5 records. I correlated most of them to the sets, and after we did about 15 of them, it was pretty clear that they're all here. So I just started counting to make sure all the records were there, and actually have some video of me playing various records. Now these sets aren't flawless. There definitely are some scuffs and some scratches. I'm trying to get a little bit of video of that here just to kind of show you guys what we're talking about. And I took just some random records out and played them, and honestly most of them look like they've hardly been played. I tried to play some of the more popular stuff, so I picked, you know, Beethoven records out, figuring those have been played more. And I picked another set that looked like it probably had been played less, and just as I thought, there's a little bit of crackling on some of the Beethoven records, and some of the records that look like they haven't been played are pretty clean. I'll show a video of those here in a moment. The other thing I wanted to point out is that some of these records are mildly warped. One of the first sets I opened just happened to be Wagner, and one of the records I put on there was warped. So I think I opened up about 10 different sets, and I went through several of them, and I didn't find any other warped records, but there's a good chance there may be some other in there, and I'll show you the video of that one as well, that just shows some mild warpings actually from this box set. And also in the video, one of the records, that first Beethoven set, has a book in it that none of the others have. The rest of them have a letter from American Express. I'm guessing these were bought through some sort of American Express deal back, I don't know, in the 80s, probably, maybe even in the 90s. Each one of them contains a letter. Most of them have a 2-page letter. Some of them have a 1-page letter. They all appeared to have one. Some of the letters have been smashed down into the box by the records, and I didn't fold all of those out because I started looking through more hastily, and it appears that they're all complete. I don't see anything missing. They all have 5 records, and everything's got its little pull tabs, and I'll walk around to the back here for a second. Just see if I can get a picture of the back. As you can see, there's a brass pull tab, and every one of those records has it on there. And I didn't pull them out by that method. I usually would just kind of shake the box around and knock the record out that way. I don't know how strong those tabs are, but some of these records are relatively snug inside of there. It took a little bit of pulling on a couple of them to get them out. Most of them come out pretty easily, but there are probably 4 or 5 of them there that were pretty difficult to get out. I think the fact that we've loosened them up now might actually make them a little easier to deal with, but just be aware, you know, they've been stored in an unknown state in an unknown location. I've only had these in my possession for a couple of weeks now, and I'm a record collector myself, so I just want to make sure that I'm doing my best to show what shape they're in. But overall, you know, it's a complete collection. I know some of these records are out of print and very difficult to get a hold of, and getting a hold of an entire collection is probably going to take a while, but here's all 30 record sets. All of them have 5 records, a total of 150, all with their books and all with their cases, ready for your collection. Thanks for taking a look, and I'll show you the videos right after this of the records playing and just some of the other shots of the inside. Thanks. Yeah.